Peatlands, they have the superpower, they can store carbon for thousands of years. Even though they occupy approximately 3% of the land surface, they store 25% of global soil organic carbon. It's a huge amount. So only tropical forest and Arctic permafrost store more carbon. They are suffering from high temperature and low water regime, and that's where vegetation is changing.
Measuring in 3, 2, 1.
We are measuring spectral properties of peatland vegetation, and this data can help us in the future to derive the information from satellite images. We know that the northern peatlands are drained out and the water table decreases, and we know that sphagnum mosses are affected by these changes, and they're drying out and they're dying. And instead of the sphagnum, the bushes and sedges come in, and that's where the peatlands are coming greener. But it doesn't mean that it's better, it means that the environment is changing. And if we know that these particular sphagnum mosses have these spectral properties, then maybe with a satellite image that has is sensing the data in the same spectra, we can derive this information about these mosses, and we can simply map them on the map, and we will trace in time how this mosses changes. In 2008, I think it was a very popular book, 6 Degrees, Our Future on Hotter Planet. At the time, like 10 years ago, I read the book and I was like, okay, the clever people from the future will solve this problem somehow. And this spring, maybe you noticed, there was extremely high temperature in Pakistan, like 49 degrees Celsius. They say that more than 1 billion of people in Pakistan and India now live on the territory affected by these heat waves. I'm like, okay, so I'm already in the future, but this problem was not solved yet. And that's why we are working in the peatlands. So we are becoming these clever people who should do something regarding climate change mitigation. So even though we are in Finland, even though we are measuring the peatlands, but it's connected to the global environment.